Yes, sir. Good morning, students. So today I am going to talk about the backup in virtualization environment. Okay, here there are like we are going to use for the two types of approaches to performing the backup on the virtual environment. One is traditional backup approach, then image based backup approach. Here, like what is the traditional backup approach? You look at this diagram. There are traditional backup approaches. Here we are going to taken as the backup agent runs on the virtual machines as well as the backup agent runs on the hypervisors. The like whatever the file, like whatever the virtual files or whatever the what is that backup applications, okay, that everything it is going to works on the virtual environment. Means each applications has to be executed on the virtual machines, but at the virtual machines, okay, and it is going to having the physical virtual device, okay, it is going to taken care of the all the backup files on that particular device on the virtual environment. But here backup agent runs on the hypervisor. Here what it will happen means the backup agent, okay, it is having all the applications, okay, the backup agent, okay, it is going to works on the backup agent hypervisor. Means there, okay, in the virtual machines, the virtual environment, okay, or like one of the physical machines, okay, so one of the physical device, okay, it is having the all the backup copy, through that they are going to executed on the virtual environment. But in the hypervisor, here all the backup copy, okay, it is having the backup agent, okay, the backup agent, it's consisting set of applications or files, okay, whenever they want to execute it, okay, they are going to execute it on the hypervisor environment. So this is about the difference between the virtual machine as well as the hypervisor backup agent. But in the image based backup, here the application server, storage and proxy server and backup device, okay, they all are working as the image based backup device. How it is means the application, the client has to be transmit or it is going to execute the applications, okay, through the storage as well as the proxy server. Here the proxy server as well as the storage, okay, it is going to work as the backup file or backup device in the single image, means which is nothing but, okay, it is going to store, okay, it is going to store all the images, okay, on the single file, okay, that single image it is going to act as the backup device. You look at this application server, okay, the application server, whatever the image, okay, means the one image, it is going to stores multiple copy of data or multiple copy of files. So here the image, here the proxy server as well as the storage device, it is going to act as the backup client. Whatever the data or whatever the applications, okay, it's having the proxy server as well as the storage, okay, it is going to send to the application server. The application server, it is going to again send back to the particular file to the backup device through the storage node as well as the proxy server. Which means the proxy server, here it is going to act as the backup client as well as the storage server. See, this is what the image based backup. The main difference between the traditional as well as the image based backup, here the image based backup, we are going to store the multiple copies of files or multiple copies of data in the single file or single image, okay, that image we are going to send to the backup device with the help of storage as well as the proxy server. And the proxy server as well as the storage, here works as backup client, or it may be host. see, this is about the image based backup. But in the traditional base, we are going to use for the two types. One is client agent on the virtual machines. The one more is client agent on the hypervisor. Whatever the virtual file, we are going to execute it on the virtual environment, and the client, the hypervisor side, all the files, okay, it is going to taken care by the agent, okay, the client agent, okay, so it is going to have the all the applications based on the requirement. It is going to executed on the hypervisor environment. So see, this is the about difference between the image as well as the traditional. Then what is the data archive? First of all, what is the data? The data, which is nothing but it should be anything, okay, the data, okay, it may be it may be a file, or it may be documents, or it may be pictures, okay, or it may be or it may be audio, video, okay. Everything you should be a data, okay. Whatever the data we are having, that everything we are going to save in one of the device, that device we are going to call it as the archive device, or it should be a archive method. Here we are going to talk about the data archive in that fixed content as well as the archives. Like, what is the fixed content here? The fixed content here, the data is we are going to access as well as the modified, okay, based on the different frequencies between the time, okay. And some of the data, okay, do you know that what is the online transaction processing applications, okay, they have to give an amount of time, okay, we have to process that particular transactions. After that, okay, that should be discarded. So this is about the fixed content, means the given amount of time or the given durations, whatever the data or whatever the changes we have to do, or whatever the task we have to perform, you have to done it. Otherwise, we cannot able to do it. After that time will be got over, we cannot able to do anything. So this is about the fixed content. And whatever the data we are after that, whatever the task we are completed, that everything it is going to stored on the archives, or it may be a backups. For example, fixed content it should be a email message, or it may be a web pages, or it may be digital media, okay. See, these all are the example of the fixed content data. And see here, you look at this. See, this is the example of the fixed content. Here, see, these all are the x-rays and that photograph, okay. These all are the fixed content. And here we are going to use for the that fixed content data, we are going to use for the one of the database, or it should be metadata. Means that data, okay, it is going to fixed in the permanent. So this is about the fixed drive. Here we are going to use for the three types of archives. One is online archive and nearline archive, then offline archive. The online archive, okay, the storage device is directly connected to the host, okay, the host. The data, it should be available immediately, means whenever the client has to access the data from the Google, or it may be anywhere, the data will be available immediately. Such type of archives we are going to call it as the online archive. But nearline archive means whenever the client has to access that particular data on the storage device, okay, first it will getting to loaded that data on that particular server. After that, it is going to available, means after amount of date, amount of time, or after amount of schedule, okay, we can access that information on the storage device. Such type of data we are call it as the nearline archives. But offline archive, the storage device, okay, it doesn't connect to the client, means the client, he or she never use for the storage device, means the everything will be a manual, means the person has to be store the data in the manual, means in the documentations, okay, they have to maintain for the hard copy. So this type